Now they have given the two equations or four equations. They given copper react with sodium chloride solution. Okay, this is one. The second reaction is aluminium plus magnesium chloride solution. Okay, third one. Silver plus ferrous sulfate solution. Fourth one, copper plus silver nitrate solution. They are given four equations. Which reaction is displacement reaction? The question is what? Which reaction is displacement reaction? Now see the same this particular question they have asked from 8th standard, 9th standard, even a 10th NEET exams, almost all different type of exam they ask. Now what are you supposed to know? What is the background for this? First you must know what is activity series, right? Activity series. Potassium is more reactive element. Sodium, next comes calcium, is it not? Magnesium and aluminium, zinc, and what else? Iron. See, this you have to remember very well. Tin, lead, and hydrogen. Hydrogen is the reference. I'll tell you what it is. Copper, silver, gold, and platinum. Platinum is the most non-reactive. It is more powerful, most reactive element. This is called activity series. You know the activity series. Aluminium displaces zinc. Potassium can displace sodium. Potassium can displace copper. Sodium can displace any of the element below. Magnesium can displace any of the element below by liberating hydrogen. Lead can displace copper, but it can't liberate hydrogen. Okay. Therefore, what here? Copper. Copper where it is? Copper is below the sodium, is it not? Therefore, which is more powerful? It is very strong. It is very much attached. Copper cannot displace sodium because sodium is above the hydrogen. Aluminium and magnesium. Aluminium here. Magnesium. Which is more powerful? Magnesium is powerful or aluminium is powerful? Magnesium is more powerful. Therefore, aluminium cannot displace magnesium. Silver, and now you take it. AgFeSO4. Ag is here. Ferrous is here. Iron. Therefore, iron can displace. See, Ag cannot displace. Right? Ag also cannot displace. Copper, yes. Copper and silver nitrate. Out of this, here is possible. Copper can displace silver. Therefore, what will happen? Here what you get? Copper nitrate or cupric nitrate plus silver precipitate. These are only possibilities, right? Therefore, this is the correct answer because copper, you complete the reaction. S, you write it. S is what? Solid. Silver is the solution. Therefore, aqueous, you have to write it. Copper, write it. This also aqueous. This is a black precipitate of silver, you get it. This is the correct answer. See, normally this type of question they will ask in multiple choice question. Multiple choice question for 1 mark. Now, here, one thing you have to remember. See, remember calcium can displace magnesium. See, for iron you take it. Iron is coated with zinc. Zinc coating. To protect rusting. This is called galvanization. It's called galvanization. Therefore, remember the word galvanization. That means coating of zinc to prevent rusting is called galvanization. This is also for, they'll ask you for multiple choice question. 1 mark. Even aluminium, here aluminium is a good, see, aluminium, multiple choice question they've asked. Aluminium is a metal, it is a good aluminium. Aluminium is a good thermal conductor. It has good thermal conductivity, and next it is malleable. It has high malleability, that is MALLEABILITY, L-I-T-E, malleability. That means what? You can make it a sheet, right? And ductility also. Ductility is not the some extent. And high melting point. It has high melting point. Therefore, it is used for utensils. It is used for utensils. Most multiple choice questions they will ask you. That also. Therefore, remember, malleable sheet. When I write sheet, what you have to, which word you have to get? Malleable. Malleability. If you are drawn into wire, means ductility. These are the word. Use it properly. Remember, most of the metals are what? Solid, except mercury. Mercury at room temperature. That is a liquid, okay? Mercury is certain. Then what is the potassium, sodium and lithium? See, lithium, sodium and potassium, right? What do you call this name? These are called alkali metals. Alkali metals. These alkali metals are soft. Very important. They are soft, especially sodium. You can cut, and more reactive also. Very, very reactive. That is why they kept under kerosene. Okay. You know, sodium especially react with water, form what? Sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen. Some hissing sound. These are all we have done already. Therefore, multiple choice question they will ask you. Now, what do you mean by corrosion here? What? See, aluminium also they coat with tin. Remember, aluminium vessels, they'll coat with tin. Understood? Therefore, for food can we use it. Because this aluminium immediately react with what? It is more reactive than the lead. Aluminium react with oxygen and it forms a white water coating, aluminium oxide. It is toxic in nature. Toxic in nature. Even copper also. All these things are some of the things they will coat with zinc or tin and all the things. They are utilized for utensils. Okay. Therefore, what is the corrosion? Next, I'll tell you what I mean by corrosion. Corrosion. See, you keep the iron, okay, iron or aluminium, all any other metals, some of the metals, certain metals, when you left it alone, immediately after a long time, it will react with the oxygen of air, moisture in air, okay, and some chemical substance like some acids, some chemical substance like certain acids form a thin coating. Iron is called rusting. Here also aluminium oxide, you get it. Therefore, this heating up of the metal, after some time what happens? This oxide, it forms an oxide and heats up the metal. Therefore, heating up of metals or corroding, this is also called corrosion, or heating up of the metal by action of air, moisture and certain chemical substances such as acid on the surface is called corrosion. Therefore, definition of corrosion is one mark. Okay. See, all these things are given in your notes, in the textbook or guide or your tuition notes or your friends. See, or YouTube, go through all that. When I ask you what is a corrosion, you have to be able to tell. Right? Therefore, I'm telling you what is the meaning of this. Right? Therefore, corrosion is the process of heating up of the metal by the action of or exposure. This is when metals are exposed for a long time, it forms a thin coating, right? That is due to the action of oxygen or air or water or some chemical substance on the surface of the metal. This process is called corrosion. Methods of prevention of corrosion. What are the methods? By painting. Painting, oiling and greasing. You can prevent corrosion by what? Painting, oiling or plastic coating. Or chromium plating, tin plating, that is tin plating, or chromium plating. Next, where is tin plating, chromium plating and all for aluminium? Next, galvanizing or plating. That means, say example, iron plate or copper plate, they'll put a thin coating of zinc, right? Thin coating of zinc. This process is called galvanizing. Next, alloy. alloying. Say example, iron rust, but this is the metal. Along with the major metal, I'll add some more metals, some other metals, like and non-metals with certain proportions, right? When you add this, what you get? The mixture of metals with the molten iron, and it will not rust. Rusting character changes. Example, steel. They add proper proportion of carbon, or they retain certain percentage of carbon. The corrosion is due to the carbon present there, or some other reasons, but don't bother about that. Here, alloying in the sense, what is an alloy? Next, alloy definition you must know. Alloy. Alloy is a homogeneous mixture. This is important. Homogeneous mixture of two or more elements are metals and non-metals, right? Therefore, this is the major metal. Along with this, they'll add one with certain proportions, some material, some metal or non-metal. This together is called the homogeneous mixture, right? Homogeneous mixture of metal and two or more metals and non-metals. This is a homogeneous, this is called an alloy. It changes its characteristics of rusting or corrosions, and it improves the quality of the utensils or appliances, whatever it is, okay? Conductivity increases, thermal conductivity increases, electrical conductivity increases or changes, and depend upon the requirement, we can change the percentage of this added metals, adding metals or non-metals, okay? Therefore, alloy is the homogeneous mixture of two or more elements or metals and non-metals, okay? Question will ask you, which process is used to obtain, right, metal from metal oxide? What is that process? Can you name the process? What is the process from metal oxide to metal? That is called reduction. Right? What is reduction? Reduction is the process by which you can convert metal to metal oxide. Just to remember this, all these things were done. Extraction of metal, purification, concentration. Okay, here you get metal oxide in some stages. Reduction of metal, you'll get pure metal. That is metal oxide. If you do the reduction process, you'll get pure metal. This is for multiple choice question there was. Therefore, every stages are very, very important, whatever we have done. Therefore, go through the previous videos. And what is the ore? It is a mineral of certain high percentage of particular metal. Then these minerals are called ores. Okay. See, here the ore contains minerals as well as mud and all this. That's called gong. Remove that wasty materials, earthly materials and all. That is called gong. Minerals will get. And the minerals are the, what is that, chemical compound or elements or compound which occur naturally in the earth crust. And out of which you can, from the metal, you will get the metal. See, metal, mineral will get metal. Profitably important. Profitably, you extract. See, iron is present in our body, but percentage is very small. Can we extract iron from our body? It is not. Therefore, one percentage of iron should be maximum in particular minerals, and extraction should be profitable. Okay. We can make diamond from carbon, but it is costlier than diamond itself. 110 times costlier than diamonds. It is not a profitable thing. By chemical process, we can convert copper to diamond. Therefore, how to extract or take out that particular metal profitably? That is correct. The elements are compound which occurs naturally in the earth crust are known as minerals, and metals can be extracted profitably from it. Okay. Now, which process is, I said, what is the process which convert metal oxide to metal? The process is called reduction. Okay. These all are multiple choice questions, right? Another multiple choice question I'll ask. See, metal oxides are given. Metallic oxide like zinc oxide, magnesium oxide and copper oxide were given. Okay. Now I suppose I have three elements. Zinc, magnesium, copper. In which case you find displacement reaction? That means metallic oxide of zinc, magnesium, copper are heated with the following metal. I am heating this zinc oxide heated with zinc, magnesium oxide and copper. Right? See, remember, in zinc oxide no displacement takes place. Because this here hydrogen you take it, zinc somewhere here and copper is somewhere here, right? Zinc cannot displace copper oxide, right? It cannot displace because zinc is zinc can displace. See here, what is the question? First you understand the question. What they given? They given three metal oxide. Okay, they given three metals: zinc, magnesium, copper. Do the zinc displace zinc? It cannot. Zinc cannot. Because first, yeah, here you remember this is hydrogen. This activity series, hydrogen. Zinc is somewhere here. Okay. Where is magnesium? Magnesium above the zinc. Magnesium is above the zinc. Zinc is somewhere. Okay, magnesium. Copper is below. Therefore, what? Zinc cannot displace zinc. But zinc can displace. Zinc can displace copper oxide, right? Zinc can displace copper oxide. Zinc oxide plus copper. This is possible. Zinc can displace copper oxide. Zinc cannot displace magnesium oxide because it is below. But magnesium can displace zinc oxide. Magnesium can displace zinc oxide, right? In zinc oxide, but copper is reactive. See, copper is less reactive, therefore it can displace. Therefore magnesium plus zinc oxide, magnesium, this is possible, this is also possible, right? Zinc plus copper oxide form, therefore this is more important. This is a type of analysis. But zinc plus magnesium oxide is not at all possible because magnesium is more reactive than zinc. Right? Therefore, magnesium cannot react. Therefore, zinc cannot replace magnesium. These are all very, very tricky questions. Even those who are going for medical or entrance exams, for them it will be used. But it is, they have asked in the SSLC 10th standard level, they will ask all this, right? Another question is which are the metal do not corrode, right? Which are the metal do not corrode easily? Can you tell me? Gold, platinum, silver. Okay. Therefore, these all are some simple general knowledge questions, and it is easy to extract also. It is non-reactive. See, there are sometimes they give like this. Most reactive metal, which is the most reactive metal? sodium. Least reactive metal? Platinum. See, I'll write sodium chloride, roasting, potassium, gold. Talk something on this. What is sodium chloride? It is a salt. It is an ionic compound. See, these are things. Sodium ion plus chloride ion is salt and ionic compound. What is roasting? Roasting is what? Heating with excess of oxygen. Okay. Heating with. Therefore, this example, remember this Bondly, right? Heating with excess of oxygen. Suppose you closed it. Heating in the closed conductor. That means what? Limited supply of oxygen. What do you call? Roasting. Other word, roasting. This is what? Calcination. What is calcination? Heating at the limited supply of oxygen called calcination. Heating with the excess of oxygen is called roasting. This is what? Multiple choice question. This is also multiple choice question. Multiple choice question. Out of this, what do you call? Most reactive. This is also most reactive metal. This is least reactive metal. Most reactive metal and least reactive metal. Understood? Therefore, by looking at certain things, you have to speak on the subject. Potassium, out of these two, most and least reactive metal. The most important question they will ask you is what? Why sodium is kept under kerosene? Why sodium is kept under kerosene? Because sodium immerses in kerosene oil because sodium metal react with air, form sodium oxide, right? Sodium oxide. And also, it react immediately, the sodium oxide immediately react with carbon dioxide form sodium carbonate. Even sodium also react with moisture. Or if you put sodium on on water, it produces a hissing sound, forming sodium hydroxide plus it liberate hydrogen. These are the reaction we already know. It's a very, very important question they may ask you for 2 mark. You know, as you know how to balance it, 2 sodium, 2 oxygen, your 2 oxygen, therefore 4 sodium, you have balanced it. You put solid, this is gas, this is solid. Then sodium carbonate, this is balanced. Sodium carbonate is solid, gas, this is solid. Sodium is solid, water is liquid, this is aqueous and this is gas. Okay? Therefore, reaction. See, now you know how to write the balance the equation. I have done it. Now, what are non-metals? Non-metals are formed by gaining of an electron. Form non-metal, they are negative ions. Say example, chlorine, it contains K shell 2 electron, L shell 8 and 7 electron. See this orbit, it want another 1 electron to form a octet structure. Therefore, it pulls 1 electron from sodium. Because sodium contains 2 electrons, 8 electrons and 1 electron here. It want to remove, it don't want this electron. If it goes out of it, what will happen? 2 is a stable, 8 is a stable. This 1 electron comes and join. It want to reject, sodium want to reject. So that sodium reject 1 electron become sodium atom. It becomes octet structure, 2 and 8. 2 and 8 are stable structure. But whereas chlorine, it will take 1 electron right? Therefore, 2, 8 and 8 become, therefore chlorine becomes negative ion. Therefore, this is a non-metal. Sodium is a metal, it is a non-metal. Therefore, some of the physical properties, metals are negative character, non-metals are negative character, metals are positive characters. Now, properties of metals, they are brittle, break easily. See, this is not that sodium. Sodium is like a rubber, it can cut, it is soft. It's not, sorry, it's chlorine, non-metals I am talking about. Carbon, you take it. Now, carbon is a brittle, it can be break, easily breakable. They are non-malleable. Therefore, non-malleable. They are non-ductile. They are non-ductile. All are solid. See, all are, see, solid or gas, except bromine. It is a liquid. Another thing, they do not conduct electricity. Do not conduct heat or electricity. But except carbon, graphite, no? Graphite is a good conductor, very important, good conductor, though it is non-metal, because of its structure, electronic structure. They are very low tensile strength. They have low tensile strength. They appear very dull. Dull appearance. They generally are soft, brittle and soft. Some are soft and some are brittle. Some are gases. Okay. But what about this diamond? Diamond is very, very hard. It's carbon only, but it has a different structure. And they have low density. Low density. Again, they are brittle, break easily, non-malleable, non-ductile. They are solid or gas. Some are liquids. Chlorine and all gases is not. Bromide is liquid. Do not conduct heat or electricity. But graphite is a good conductor. The majority are soft, but diamond is very, very hard. Low tensile strength. It appears dull, dull appearance, and low density. These are the properties of, physical properties of the metal. Okay. Now, here, what are the chemical properties? Chemical properties of non-metals. Here first, reaction with oxygen. Metal of chemical properties, reaction with non-metals. Example, carbon, you take it. Alright. Carbon react with oxygen, the gas, form, oxygen is a gas, right? Form carbon dioxide. That is what? Metal plus non-metal plus oxide forms non-metal oxide.